The most common type of trig function that you have to integrate is a product of sines and cosines. So something of the form, the integral of sine to some power times cosine to some power dx. Now, in this video, we're going to talk about how to do that when n is odd or m is odd. When n and m are both even, it's more complicated. We'll get to that in the next video. So let's talk about the simplest case. The simplest case is when m is 1. So you've got 1 power of cosine and a bunch of sines. So how do you do that? Well, this is a case of u substitution. All you need to do is let u equal sine of x, and then du is cosine of x dx. So this part is just du, and this part is u to the n. The integral of u to the n du is u to the n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus a constant. And that's sine to the n plus 1 of x over n plus 1 plus a constant. Pretty easy. Okay, the next simplest case is where m is an odd number that isn't 1, like 3 or 5 or 7. Let's do an example where we have 3 powers of cosine. Now, we'd like to have 1 power of cosine because we know how to handle that. But we can convert 2 cosines to a sine using the formula cosine squared equals 1 minus sine squared. So we rewrite this as the integral of sine squared of x times 1 minus sine squared of x. That's cosine squared. And then you have 1 cosine left. And then, as before, we let u equal sine of x. And this becomes the integral of u squared times 1 minus u squared du. So it's the integral of u squared minus u to the fourth du. And that's just u cubed over 3 minus u to the fifth over 5 plus a constant. And if you spell that out, that's sine of x cubed over 3 minus sine of x to the fifth over 5 plus a constant. So the cases where you have an odd number of cosines are almost as easy as a case where you have 1 cosine, because you can convert it into the case where you have 1 cosine. You just swap 2 powers of cosines for 1 minus sine squared. If you need to, swap 2 more, swap 2 more, swap 2 more. Swap all but 1 power of cosine into sines, and then do a u substitution. Okay. The next case is where you have only 1 power of sine. In that case, you want to do the u substitution where u is cosine of x. In that case, du is minus sine of x dx, and this becomes minus the integral of u to the m du. So this becomes minus u to the m plus 1 over m plus 1 plus a constant. So you wind up with minus cosine to the m plus 1 of x over m plus 1 plus a constant. Again, not hard. This is essentially du. Well, it's minus du. And this is u to the m. So you have u to the m times minus du, and that's an easy integral. Now, the next case, it works when n is an arbitrary odd number. Then instead of using sine squared equals 1 minus cosine squared, instead of using cosine squared equals 1 minus sine squared to convert cosines to sines, use sine squared equals 1 minus cosine squared to convert all but one of the sines to cosines. So if you wanted the integral of sine cubed times cosine squared, you'd say that's the integral of 1 minus cosine squared of x times cosine squared of x. That's sine squared, that's cosine squared. You still have a sine left. And then you say, let's let u equal cosine of x. Du is minus sine of x dx. And this becomes the integral of u to the fourth minus u squared du. U squared minus u to the fourth times minus du. And so that's u to the fifth over 5 minus u cubed over 3. And so that's cosine to the fifth of x over 5 minus cosine cubed of x over 3 plus a constant. Great. Now, what if they're both odd? Do you convert sines to cosines, or do you convert cosines to sines? And the answer is you can do it either way. You could convert sines to cosines and say this is the integral of sine of x times cosine cubed of x times 1 minus cosine squared of x, and then let u equal cosine of x. That works just fine. Or if you'd rather, you can convert cosines to sines. You could say this is the integral of sine cubed of x times 1 minus sine squared of x, that's two of your cosines, times cosine of x dx, and then let u equal sine of x. Either method will work. Neither one is better than the other. You have a choice. Finally, what if n and m are both even? If n and m are both even, then the tricks we've talked about in this video fall flat on their face. You need totally different methods, and that's what we're going to talk about in the next video.